Good morning, and thank you for taking the time to celebrate and recognize Guilford County Schools' outstanding graduates in the class of 2024. This class is comprised of more than 5,000 graduates. They started high school in one of the most disruptive times in our country. On top of typical angst associated with going to high school, these students had the added stress of learning at home during their freshman year in the COVID-19 pandemic. This class has faced unimaginable challenges and has persevered. Our teachers, our counselors, and our school staff have worked tirelessly to be champions for our students and to help them reach this exciting milestone. I am grateful for their work, and I am so proud of the outstanding progress of our students. Today, we have a group of extraordinary young people who are shining examples of the class of 2024. I'll introduce you to them and ask them to stand when their names are called. Paul Evans Robinson from Eastern Guilford High. Lily Newcomb from Penn Griffin School for the Arts. Bailey Wright from Western Guilford High. Stefan Scalco from Northwest Guilford High. And Holly Tatini from Page High. Miguel Corona from Southeast Guilford High. And Sophia Mahmood from Southern Guilford High. Now I'm going to allow each of you to share a little bit about yourself, your experience in Guilford County Schools, and where you're headed next, and we'll start with Paul.
Hello, everyone. My name is Paul Evans Robinson. As an upcoming graduate of the class of 2024, I am thankful for being able to get an education through Guilford County Schools. Throughout my 13 years of being a student with GCS, I have been blessed to have and meet the best teachers and staff members that have helped shape me into the best young man and student I can be. My favorite memories throughout my time would be being involved in GCS events such as the North Carolina A&T Male Exploring Pathway in Education, GCS Superintendent Student Advisory Council, the Senior Spotlight Interview, and all 13 years of being a student, a part of Guilford County Schools. My plans after high school are to obtain my bachelor's degree from North Carolina State University in architecture and further into getting my master's in architecture and help support my family.
Hello, my name is Lily Newcomb and I currently attend Penn Griffin School for the Arts. My high school experience was not like most because of the impacts from COVID-19. However, at Penn Griffin, our small class sizes immensely contributed to my success because I got so much closer with my classmates, and my teachers sincerely really did care about me and my work. My senior counselor prepared me so much for anything that could come at me with college applications and essays, and she knew every single senior and their passions and goals. After graduation, I will attend Queen's University of Charlotte to pursue a degree in music therapy, and after college, I will be board-certified music therapist. Attending a art school really did help me channel my passions for singing and being on stage and just really being around other people, and I hope to take those skills that I have acquired and apply them to my profession. Overall, my time here in GCS as a student was very positive, and I hope I will take those connections and the skills and apply them to my whole entire life. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Bailey Wright, and I go to Western Guilford High School. My 13-year journey with Guilford County Schools has not been short of experiential opportunities. This has allowed me to explore my interests by taking advantage of both the drone technology pathway and AP Capstone program at Western Guilford High School. Through the drone pathway, I was able to obtain an FAA Part 107 drone license and learn about how drone flight can be intertwined with various sectors, including the medical field. The AP Capstone program has allowed me to explore my own unique interests by reading a variety of research papers to develop my own research topic. Through this process, I was able to conduct research on the STEM belonging of level of women and underrepresented groups at my school and write a research paper that comprehensively reviewed various parts of regenerative medicine. Gaining exposure to both of these unique magnet programs have greatly influenced my decision to major in biomedical engineering at Duke University. Within this career path, I intend to make medical devices more effective while decreasing risk of complications during and after implementation. Some of my greatest memories from my time at GCS stem from the clubs that I have been a part of, drone events, and simply being in the classroom. As for clubs, DECA meetings and competitions allow me to foster meaningful and collaborative friendships that encourage the growth of my leadership capabilities. Drone events, from promoting TDL Academy at outreach events to conducting drone flight demonstrations, have driven me to step out of my comfort zone by being a part of more hands-on and out-of-the-classroom experiences. Alternatively, being in the classroom setting has pushed me to learn in new ways while engaging in open dialogue with peers regarding topics that span from opinions on books we read in AP Lit to what the best Marvel movie is. These conversations have made me realize that listening to the perspectives of others with an open mind is where real growth is cultivated. Overall, I am so grateful for the supportive community created by GCS, and though I'm excited for my future endeavors, I will also miss being a part of the only school system I have ever known. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Stefan Scalco. Throughout my years of being a student attending Guilford County Schools, I have learned important life skills. I have met new people that have impacted and supported me throughout my educational pathway. My favorite part about attending Guilford County Schools is becoming close with the teachers that have helped me become the person I am today. My next step for my upcoming 4 years will be starting the Guilford Apprenticeship Program to become a technician with Cross Company, an electrical engineering company. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Anjali Tatini, and I'm a student at Page High School. I initially had a lot of fears when I transferred from an online school program to Page my junior year, but I was immediately met with the most welcoming community. As an IB student, I found myself a part of a highly motivated and inspiring group of students that helped in creating a positive and enthusiastic learning environment, one that I seek to continuously build going into the future. I'm grateful for my IB teachers, Mrs. McGeehy, Mr. Abel, and Mrs. Smitherman specifically, for fostering this environment and pushing students to reach their full potential. I received immense support from my counselor, Ms. Rich, and principal, Dr. Nagley, as well, who worked hard to make sure that each student felt that they could pursue each of their aspirations. GCS has also provided me with many opportunities that extended beyond the classroom. I've been lucky to be a member of Page's girls tennis team, and I have also been a part of many clubs such as Student Council, the IB Student Advisory Board, and I even founded my own pickleball club. I am grateful that GCS has allowed me the chance to grow as a student, an athlete, and a person, while creating connections with many amazing people. This fall, I will be attending Duke University, and I plan to double major in global health and psychology on the pre-med track. I hope to eventually attend medical school with the aspiration of becoming a surgical neonatologist. I am incredibly grateful for my time as a student with GCS, and I'm excited about the future. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Miguel Corona, and thank you for having me. I've attended Guilford County Schools my whole life. I graduated from Sumner Elementary and then went off to Southern Middle School and finished my eighth grade year at Southeast Middle School. We were told we were going to have 2 weeks off to school, and that extended to about a year and a half. The second time I walked into a school, I was a sophomore at Southeast Guilford High School, where I've spent most of my time as a dual athlete. I do soccer and wrestling. I've connected with so many people, and not just in my school because of these sports. And I have plenty of friends in all Guilford County schools. My favorite memories were the rivalries between the schools and the shouting back and forth in wrestling matches. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Sophia Mahmood, and I'm beyond elated to be here today. In all honesty, Guilford County Schools has given me the tools and connections I needed to get where I am today. The people I've met, learned from, and bonded with will forever remain with me and have molded me into who you see today. I started at Oakview Elementary before transferring to Allen J. Elementary in first grade, progressing to Southern Guilford Middle School, and finishing my time with GCS at Southern Guilford High School. Guilford County competently prepares the students for the competitive workforce along with their post-secondary aspirations. I'm simply one of those products. It would not be possible without the unwavering support of the family I have built within Guilford County. One opportunity that shaped me the most was going through the Southern Guilford EMT program, the first and only right now. It is the first EMT program offered in GCS at the high school level, and I was a part of its pilot crew. I learned basic skills like CPR and performed advanced skills such as airway adjunct insertion and medication administration, and even completed my clinical rotation on an ambulance with Guilford County EMS, one of the best EMS services in the state. The rigorous course load did make me question life at times. However, However, this program would be non-existent without the vision of Ms. Britton Wirtz, my EMT instructor, and the support of Dr. Brian Muller, our principal. She pushed tirelessly for 6 months, for her six students to have a fighting chance. In her doing so, I became the first high school EMR, emergency medical responder, in Guilford County Schools. This is the lowest level in the hierarchy that follows. Emergency medical responder, EMT, emergency medical technician, AEMT, advanced EMT, and paramedic. As for my post-secondary aspirations, I am attending Guilford College to study forensic biology. I do plan to utilize my certifications and work as an EMT simultaneously. I am still deciding whether to immerse myself in the crime scene investigation branch or attend medical school to become a medical examiner. However, I am open to whatever God has in store for me. His blessings have gotten me to this point, and I depend on his blessings for the future. Thank you.
Impressive, right? As you begin to chart your own course, I do hope that you'll remember the lessons that you learned here, the teachers who encouraged you and helped you realize those passions, and the coaches who showed you how great you could be if you put in the work, and the friends who supported you through all the ups and downs of childhood. There are many paths that you may choose to take, whether it be college, the military, or jumping into the workforce, but no matter how far you get on your path, remember you always have a home in Guilford County Schools. Please join me in congratulating these outstanding graduates for their remarkable achievements. Good job. So, as I mentioned before, these extraordinary graduates are just a small sample of GCS's outstanding students in Guilford County Schools. The number of workforce credentials students earned has increased by 178% over the past 3 years. Through our more than 48 choice schools and 66 choice programs, our neighborhood schools, career and technical education, and career and college promise programs, we are providing students opportunities to gain the skills they will need to compete and succeed in a global economy. This year, GCS saw a 46% increase in dual enrollment through the College and Career Promise program compared to just a 12% increase statewide. Nearly 2,000 GCS students took advantage of this unique opportunity to earn college credit, certificates, diplomas, and valuable skills to set them up for success. According to GTCC, GCS students who have earned a credential through College and Career Promise have saved more than $670 million in the fall of 2022 and more than $630 million in the spring of 2023 in tuition. The mission of Guilford County Schools is to graduate responsible citizens. This year, a record 604 seniors will receive an additional service learning diploma for their work to improve this county and our country. Our seniors have completed more than 216,000 service learning hours, which translate to more than $6.5 million in economic impact. Now, I'd like to invite the seniors with us this morning to join me over here. So we're going to get up and walk over there. So I am proud to announce that the GCS's graduating class of 2024 has earned a total of 181,086,594 in scholarships this year alone. Congratulations. Our seniors are about to embark on an exciting journey, and we're excited for what their future holds. Many people are leaving home, but we hope they include coming back to Guilford County in their plans. Students from our teacher cadet programs will also join us today. This year, they've partnered with veteran teachers in GCS, getting a hands-on lesson about what it means to be an educator. They've assisted students in elementary, middle, and high school reach their highest potential. With the looming teacher shortage, districts must deploy innovative strategies to recruit teachers and build the bench. North Carolina's teacher cadet program began in 1997. Many GCS teacher cadet alumni are now working in the district as educators and administrators. Can you get my piece of paper that's left up there? Thank you. These students are going to college with some training already, so we need to make sure that salaries remain competitive in North Carolina to keep great teachers here. This is another example of how many graduates are leaving GCS better prepared for the world and ready to give back to our community. I'm proud to see how these students will shape the face of public education in the future. And in just a few minutes, representatives from our Human Resources Department will come up to share a few remarks to recognize these seniors. This concludes the first portion of the graduation media briefing.